morning to you. It's Saturday the 29th of April 2017, boys and girls. A very warm welcome to this morning's United Kingdom Talk, coming from our purpose-built television studios here in Royal Berkshire. Yes, indeed it is. I've been very busy this morning already. I got up, do you know, I went to bed last night about 2 o'clock in the morning. A great night last night at the karaoke. Really wonderful. And we welcomed last night Johnathan from Ireland. He came all the way from Ireland and he's been watching both these chat shows and karaoke shows on his equipment at his home in Ireland. He came all the way from Ireland last night to see us and sung a song at the end. So thank you, Johnathan. I hope you had a nice night last night. I didn't see you at the end to say goodbye to you, but I hope you had a nice night last night. We had someone come up and saying it was a triplet. Three people. Is that a triplet? Is it a threesome? No, that's something else, isn't it? Was it a triplet? What's three people coming up to sing? What would you call that? A gaggle of singers? A selection of singers? A triplet of singers? No, it doesn't sound right, triplet. There's quartet. What's three? I don't know what three is. Oh. No, not sure. Anyway, so we had three singers come up last night and they sang Who Wants to Live Forever? Who Wants to Live Forever? You know that song by Queen, an excellent band, top band Queen. So they sang Who Wants to Live Forever, at which point I pointed to the owner, the part owner, Duncan, and I said, if you want to live forever, there's an example of what you're going to look like. And he turned, well, if looks could kill, dear. I mean, it was only a passing comment, for God's sake. No offence was intended. Never any offence intended. So that was that. Nice journey in, nice journey home as well. I got back, cleaned up after the cat, went to bed about 2:30. Well, I was up again this morning at 8 o'clock. I don't know why. The alarm went, well, not alarm. I just woke up. I don't wake up to an alarm in the morning. I'm very, very fortunate that I don't have to wake up to an alarm. How many of you are like that, eh? Oh, I'm so lucky. But I'm waking up like 8 o'clock in the morning. So no point in hanging around. You just lay in there. What, you're going to wait in bed to die? You know, don't understand these people who have duvet days. What is that about? Duvet days. Well, you literally just sit under the duvet, either in a bed or on a sofa all day. We never had that when we were children. Duvet days. God's sake. Well, you just hang around the house and do nothing. What is the point of that? No, got to get up and do something. So I had my porridge once again, cleaned up after the cat, put the cat outside. And after my breakfast, I watered the garden. It is bone dry out there. Went round to my mate's house the other day. He's not been too well. He's had a bad chest infection. I tell you what, don't those antibiotics work quick? God, in the morning, and this particular morning, he'd started the antibiotics a couple of days before. He had a chest infection. And in the morning, I had a FaceTime with him on the mobile phone. And he looked like, you know, he looked like he had about 10 minutes left. I won't lie to you. I thought, oh, my, I'm going to ring later and he's going to be dead. That's what I thought. I'm sorry. I speak as I find. You won't get any crap out of me. I'll just tell you. He looked like, well, I'd be lucky to say if he had 10 minutes, maybe five. 5 minutes, I reckon he had. Anyway, so that was in the morning. A few hours later, he FaceTimed me. What a difference a few hours had made. He was alive again. I was so disappointed. I've got life insurance on that bloke, you know. I was going to buy a lovely new house with that money. But there you go, he's alive again. So I popped around his house on Thursday in the afternoon, because of course, you know, he might look better, but he's still not quite there yet, to water his garden, because his garden was bone dry. I was going to do mine, but I thought I'd go and do his instead. So I went up to do his. His hanging baskets, well, he's got, they're not pansies. What are those little things? A little bit like violas, but oh, they might be violas. Are they violas? Little flowers similar to pansies, but much smaller, whatever they are. Anyway, two of these hanging, what are they, like that? You know, hanging baskets and flowers. They've got to be like that. Like this sunflower, strangely enough, which has appeared at the right moment behind me. Look at that. My dancing sunflower. Have you seen this before? Sunshine. Whoa, we're walking on sunshine. You want one of those, don't you? Gustav, you're not having that. You're not having my... I know, I can see your beady eyes looking at my son thing. You're not having that, my friend. You're absolutely not having that. Anyway, so his hanging basket, instead of being like that, his hanging baskets were like that. One of them looked like it had even less time to live than he did when I'd had FaceTimed him earlier. It was like that. You know, and it's just surprising. You give it a bit of water and a couple of hours later, it was like that. And then another couple of hours later, it was like that. And I saved the life of my friend's hanging basket. I'm very pleased to announce that. So this morning, I thought I'd water my own garden. It'd take me about an hour to go around with the spray. I don't like to turn the sprinkler thing on too much. That uses so much water. So I go around with my... watering the garden. The cat follows me around. When she's not turning in circles, and she's getting... I've got an elderly cat. She's 18 years old, completely incontinent, and spends most of her time walking around in circles. The thing is, she's getting faster and faster. Sometimes... I shouldn't laugh at my cat like this. But sometimes the cat walks around so fast, she falls over. And then she gets up and carries on again. Always anti-clockwise. I hope that's nothing to do with the Antichrist or anything like that. Always anti-clockwise, that poor little pussy. Poor old cow she is, dear. So I finished watering the garden, came back here, and here we are now. Now, there is going to be, at your request... There is going to be very soon a Chris Reardon DIY programme. It's been a long time since we've done DIY on the show. I think the last item of DIY I did was to repair the puncture on my bicycle's inner tube. And that was about 2 or 3 years ago now. I and my friend recently bought in... shouldn't really tell you this. He'd go mad if I tell you this. Come on. We purchased something in the range... bit like Tesco's Home and Wear. Okay, don't let him tell you I told you that, because he's a John Lewis man, the same as me. We're John Lewis people. But we saw this thing. I thought the cat was listening at the door. Then we saw this shoe rack in Tesco's, build it yourself type thing. So we bought one of those each. And well, I mean, when I looked at it, it looked like it'd be made out of matchwood. It was really cheap and awful. I thought, oh, sod it. Well, I put it together. No nails required, no glue or anything like this. It's just really cheap, crap wood. And it comes in two bits. There's a top bit, a bottom bit, and like four legs. That's it. And you kind of push these legs in the slats. Well, the whole thing falls apart after 2 days. Complete and utter waste of time. Utter waste of time. So I was going to chuck mine out. And I thought, no, you know, I spent a very hard-earned £3 on this item. I can't remember what it was. It was probably about tenner. It certainly wasn't worth £10. I can't remember what I paid for it. But anyway, and I thought, no, I'll try and fix it. And basically, I used glue. That's all I did. Instead of pushing the parts together, I glued them together. So put the glue on and then pushed them together. And I left it for a couple of days. And now it's fine. So, of course, I've made the foolish mistake of telling him that. He'd already put his in the bin, I believe. He's got his out of the bin, put it in the car. Yesterday he said, oh, can you fix that for me? You know, so that can be Chris Reardon's DIY show coming soon to a cinema near you with overpriced popcorn and very uncomfortable. Actually, you know, the seats in cinemas are so much better now at the Showcase. We've got a Showcase cinema. I don't know if you've got one there where you are. Showcase cinema in Wynnersh, which is here in Berkshire. And they've all got buttons, like, you know, like you're in a posh car. And you go and your legs go up, not completely flat, not like British Airways business class, not like that. But it goes back far enough. And you are so comfortable that actually you barely need to move during the entire film. Isn't that fantastic? And that's not just the premier seats. That's all the seats in there. The premier seats in the Showcase, well, they're like beds. They're like beds. You know, they're long like that and a little bit there for you to... Now, I know what you're thinking now. Bed bugs. You're thinking bed bugs. I have to tell you, and I'm not going to mention any names, but there is someone at this moment watching this show who has had bed bugs. He was bitten. Oh, I didn't mean to say he. I've revealed now the sex of the person. He was covered in bed bugs once from a place, not from his own place, but from a place where he stayed. Now, don't worry about bed bugs because it's like, you know, plasticky type stuff. I don't think they can cling to that. Little bastards, they are. They try, if they'd fall off someone onto one of those seats, they just slide off the plastic. Or if you want to be, you know, doubly careful before you sit down on one of these, give them a good spray with some anti-bedbug spray, which is available from all good retailers. And of course, on Amazon, one-click ordering. Yes. So now where did I get to with that now? I've forgotten what I was talking about now. Water and the cat. Yep, there we are. So that's what I did last night. Got in, got 8 o'clock, watered the garden, had my breakfast, cleaned up after the cat again. And here I am. In fact, the cat at the moment is still walking in very fast circles around the garden. She's really fast now. Like that. She goes like that for hours and then she falls over and goes to sleep. Bless. Poor little Katie, eh? Poor little Katie. I've got a bit of a problem at the moment, actually. I'm running out of shirts to wear. The lady who usually irons my shirts, what happens, she does Ronnie's as well, my best mate. So she takes, Ronnie usually comes over here, collects my shirts and take them. Well, I've been on holiday. He's not been well. And now she's gone on holiday. I've got about 20 shirts down there waiting to be ironed. I'm running out of shirts. That's why we've got this boring grey one on today. I'm seriously running out of shirts. I mean, I keep looking at that iron in my cupboard and I can't bring myself to brick that oven up. Iron. I cannot. Oh, it's so boring. Iron in a shirt. And it takes me so long to iron a shirt. It really does. I was going to take them down to Mrs. Patel, who runs the dry cleans. She wants like £2.50 per item. God's sake, man. The lady who does mine, you give her a great big black carrier bag type thing, and it's about 15 quid. Thank you very much. That's a fair price. £2.50 per shirt. God's sake, it's cheaper to buy one from Primark, isn't it? Primark has killed the jumble sale, wasn't it? Hey, what a shame. Did you like to go jumble sales when you were a child? I don't think jumble sales exist anymore. I'm sure they don't. Such a shame. And that smell of all the old stained and dusty clothes as you used to go into the local scout hut to rummage around through people's old underwear and shirts and things like that, looking for something to buy. Did you do that? It don't happen anymore. You just go in Primark. What I don't understand with Primark, the one in Oxford Street, I think it's two in Oxford Street, what I don't understand, you go in there and it is full of very rich Arab-type people. You know the sort. They have got so much money, it's unbelievable. And I do not understand why they go in there with empty suitcases and spend small amounts of money on lots of stuff. I don't get that at all. Whereas me, I'll be going... Actually, it's next week. I'll be taking my mate because it's his birthday Sunday. Ronnie's birthday on Sunday, but he doesn't want anyone to know that he's going to be 54 years old, 44 years old. So please don't tell anyone. It's our little secret. As a priest once said to me, it's our little secret, boys and girls. It really is. Okay, don't tell anyone that Ronnie is 44 next week. So we're going out. We're going to have Ronnie's day because for our birthdays, you see, I have a Chris's day and he has a Ronnie's day where the other one, whose day it is not, is instructed by the one whose day it is to take them out and do whatever they want to do on their birthday, perhaps purchase birthday gifts. For my birthday this year, he gave me a load of money towards my brand new iPhone SE. Yes, the SE is the one between the 6 and the 7. So it went 6, SE, 7. That's where the SE. The SE has got everything that the 6 has got, but not quite as much as the 7. And of course, it doesn't have the price of the 7 either. So he gave me a load of money towards a phone. He wants me to go to Bicester Village in Oxfordshire and purchase him some clothes. So that's what we're going to do. And of course, the United Kingdom Talk television cameras will be there to cover the event for you in full colour. That will be happening on, not live, I'm afraid. That will be a recorded programme available for all to see on the United Kingdom Talk iPlayer at a later date. OK, so that's what we're doing Tuesday and very much looking forward to that. Let's say hello to some people who are with us this morning early. Good morning to the delicious, voluptuous, beautiful Elaine, who had some excellent news this week. She had a little bit of a problem, had it cut out, had it tested. Non-malignant. Excellent news, Elaine. Excellent news, my darling. Hello to Elaine, who's with us today, who says, hi, Chris and everyone. Three people together is a trio. Thank you, Elaine. Yeah, so we had a trio of singers. Thank you for your correction. We do like a correction. Thank you, Elaine. Gustav says, good morning, lovey. What a great last night. International superstar and television personality, Chris Reardon, was on form. Do you think so? So you see, it does take other people to tell you that because you don't realise it when you're doing it. Honestly, sometimes I'll finish a night and oh, that wasn't a very good night tonight. And I might get a text message or a message from someone. Oh, it was a really good night tonight. And you don't see it yourself because you're kind of, I don't know, in the moment or something like that. Oh, it's getting a bit warm in here today. Turn on my air. I thought that wasn't working. That's broke my air conditioner. You can't see it. Oh, can I move the camera? No, I can't. Hang on a minute. You might see it on this one. Can you see this or not? Yes, you can. No, you can't see it on there. You can't see it anywhere, can you? You can't see it anywhere. Is that on there? No. Ah, there it goes. The little slats have opened. I'm pleased to say the little slats have opened. Good. What was I just saying now? Can't remember. Yes, sometimes you have to tell, someone else has to tell you that it was a good night because you really don't see it yourself. Grant says, I know what you're like with DIY. Don't do it. Oh, you're having a laugh, Grant. Oh, now, Grant used to be one of the DJs at the place I'm about to finish at, the Two Brewers in Clapham. I'm going from there. They're going to open till 3 o'clock in the morning and I can't be doing that. And that's probably going to happen around June. So we come to agreement and I shall go from there. And I've been there since 1999, so time to go now anyway. So good. I'm very happy about that. Already replaced the night, as you well know, with a new Sunday night. We're doing karaoke at the Camden Eye this Sunday night between 8 p.m. and 11 p.m. That will become regular. This is the first one, but then there'll be a two-week break because I can't do it for 2 weeks. And then after that, we'll start. So tomorrow night, that's Sunday the 30th. There's only 30 days in April, isn't there? Am I right there? 30 days in April, I'm sure there is. So Sunday night, tomorrow night, karaoke at the Camden Eye. That's in Camden. Very, very, I mean, it's almost on top of Camden Tube Station. It starts at 8 o'clock and finishes at 11 o'clock. Actually, last night, I was going to go down there tonight just to check everything out. But I actually went last night because I found out it was open till 3 o'clock last night, this place, the Camden Eye. So I popped in there last night on the way home just to check out the stuff and where I was going to plug in and all that. And nice place. Nice sound system. They've got their own speakers, so I'm not going to have to take speakers in or anything like that. So I'm very much looking forward to that. That's tomorrow night. I tell you what, Camden Town last night at about midnight, my God, what a mess. Oh, there were so many people. So all young people out, because there's a lot of bars and it's very vibrant around there. But the mess! You have never seen so much mess. Piles and piles of chip wrappers and kebab boxes on the floor. Because why are people like that? They just eat these things and drop them on the floor. Dreadful people. It was packed in Camden Town last night, walking around. I don't think I even saw it that packed when I was working at the Black Cap in Camden Town. So tomorrow night, I'm really looking forward to that. And I'm working with a very nice man called Mark, who used to run one of the Belushis that I worked out. Actually, some years ago now, I did enjoy very much working for the Belushis chain of pubs. One of my favourite, if not, what was my favourite places to... It's a bit of a toss-up, really, between the Black Cap in Camden and Belushis in either Hammersmith or London Bridge. I couldn't tell you which one I like the best. It would be one of those two, though, yeah. Good morning to Adam. So I will be doing my DIY, Grant, tomorrow. That's what I was going to say. Yeah, Grant used to be one of the DJs at the Two Brewers. And he goes on about DIY. Are you having a laugh, mate? Carl, the way you used to put things together in there, bits of wire poked in holes, and I never forget, we were showing The X Factor. I'm going back here about 6 or 7 years now, and I got to work, and honestly, there is this Freeview box balanced on a little pile of cassettes, a little pile of CDs on the stool that I was going to sit on to start my DJing with it plugged in. And it's all balanced like that. Of course, I moved it, that everything went off. Everything went off. And then there's the bass speaker that you used to fix, so-called fix, by gently pushing a wire into it so it would just keep going off. How dare you insinuate that I'm no good at DIY? Look at yourself first. Let them who has the most sin cast the first stone, as it says in the Holy Bible, Hail Mary, full of grace. Yes. Good morning to Adam, who says, can you get some circular treadmill and put Katie on it and then connect it to a car battery and then inverter and power the lights, saving the electricity bill for the United Kingdom Talk television complex? I think that's an excellent idea, Adam. We've talked about this before, haven't we? She is going fast. Last night, I was watching her last night, because as soon as I come in, I put her in the garden, so, just in case she wants a little wee in there, you know. It might save me on a few of the metros. I'm expecting soon to get a complaint from the train station up the road that I keep stealing their metros from my cat litter. Oh, here's a question for you. Maybe someone knows the answers to this. When it comes to, obviously, newspapers supposed to go in the recycle bin, but what if they've got cat mess on it? Wee or poo? I mean, is the wee all right? Or is the wee and the poo all right? Or should both go in the other way? And you're probably reading a paper this morning, boys and girls, that has got at some point in, and check it carefully, there might be a little bit of Katie's poo on that paper where it's been recycled. Isn't that a lovely thought? Recycled cat poo and then printed with newspapers on it. I like that idea very much. You see, you mustn't waste things. Don't waste things. Yes. Elaine says, maybe you should put your shirts under your mattress so they'll iron while you sleep. I don't think that'll work. No, it's got to be a flat piece of metal, Elaine, darling. Maybe I could send them over to you. What's the postage to Israel? Would you do that for me, lovey? Eh? I'll tell you what, we'll do a deal, Elaine. When I come over, probably next year sometimes, when I come back over to Israel to come and see you, and do all my tourist things again, you know, all the holy sites on Jerusalem and all that. When I come over, if I could bring a large bag, a black bag of ironing, I will come to your radio studio where you do your radio show, and I will tech op for you. I will people are wondering what that is. I'm sorry, it's a radio term. General public don't understand that. Elaine does. Elaine understands what that is. I could tech op for you. How does that sound, Elaine? I could answer the phone for you. Good morning, Elaine's radio show. Can I help you with your inquiry? I'm Chris Reardon. And they say, oh my God, not the trouble is, then they recognise my name straight away and they probably want to have a chat with me rather than put through to you, Elaine. That's the only thing for that. Maybe I could go incognito. I could secretly pretend to be someone else. You know, someone perhaps lesser unknown, like, I don't know, like Tom Hanks. Hello, Tom Hanks here. Oh, hello, Tom. Could you put me through to Elaine, please? Because they wouldn't know that name. Oh, hello. It's Shirley Bassey. Oh, hello, Shirley. Could you put me through to Elaine? But they wouldn't know those names, you see. Would they? Anyway, Elaine, there's an idea for you. Good morning to Dennis Granger. Happy birthday, Ronnie, for tomorrow. Yes, it's his birthday tomorrow. We don't do birthdays the day before. No, because he'll want more and more, dear. More and more, love. We don't do birthdays until the day before. Good morning to John Aitken. My dry cleaner does 10 shirts for £8. I can't remember the last time I ironed a shirt. Ah, maybe they do. Ah, I'm going to check that at Mrs. Patel's. I'll see if she does, like, a bulk, the special offer type thing. Did you say 8 shirts for a tenner? 10 shirts for £8. Oh, it just gets better and better, doesn't it? Eh? That's not bad. By the way, no one's noticed my new haircut, have you? You don't notice, do you? The shorter it is, the less obvious the bald bit in the middle is. Yes, we go to a different hairdressers now since our favourite one, and we did like him very much. We loved going to the hairdressers in Wokingham, but he put the price up £3 at the weekend. He kept it the same Monday to Thursday, but we go Friday. So that the reason we go Friday is that though Ronnie is spick and span, he likes to be spick and span for the weekend, you see. So that's why we go Fridays. Well, he put the one in Wokingham, he put his prices up £3. So that's the only reason we don't go. We liked him. We liked the governor. We liked all the staff in there. My favourite was I've got to tell you, I quite like that boy in there. What was his name? Brandon. He works there. Very, very nice. But my favourite hairdresser in there was the lady from Malaysia. She was always kind and gentle and talked about her family. And I always like to have a little bit of a conversation with her. That was my favourite hairdresser. But it went up £3, dear. £13. Well, £13.25 if you include the tip. I always like to give a generous tip. 25 pence is plenty, I think. Plenty. They get a whole Mars bar with that. No. So we go to the other one now in Bracknell. It's only been open 7 weeks. Known as Eden. E-D-E. Eden Barbers. Oh, it's lovely in there. Actually, I did make a little video of it. I can't show it to you now because I haven't put it on the system. But I'll show it to you perhaps in the recorded when we do the DIY video. I might show you that. I have to say, very good looking barbers in there. Oh, God, Mediterranean. Look, they look like they're from someone like Iraq or somewhere like that. That colour and the jet black stub. Oh, gorgeous. And he's got a smile, dear. And the smile is kind of saying, I think I'm sure he's a straight lad, but the smile he's giving me is, I know I'm straight and I know you're gay and I know you fancy me. That is the smile I'm getting from him. You know that smile, lads, don't you? I'm straight. I know you're gay. And I know you fancy me. It's one of those smiles. Oh, well. I can look, can't I? Yes. So we have our hair cut there now on a Friday. Ronnie actually goes every week. I go every other week. But I go up there with him on the other week. We can't be affording to go every week, dear. God's sake, man. I've got birthdays coming up here. I've got my nephew to get a birthday present from. He was 32 yesterday. There's Evie, great niece, who was 5 on Tuesday this week. Harry, he's going to be 4. I think four in a couple of weeks. It goes on and on. There's my niece, Tracy Clifford. It was her birthday. I haven't sorted out her birthday present this week yet. It goes on and on. And there's another one about to be dropped. I haven't heard anything yet. As soon as I've heard my niece has had the baby, I shall rush up to the studios here of United Kingdom Talk and announce it to the world to see. OK, as soon as I'm given permission, because I don't like to say these things until she says, I say, can I tell everyone yet? And she might say no, she might say no. And then later on, she said, OK, you can tell everyone now. Do you know what I mean? So that's nice. Elaine, you see, like minds think alike. Elaine also has the Apple iPhone SE. Now, this brilliant phone, isn't it? Wonderful phone. And you don't pay the price of the 7. You see, that's the secret. If you want a brand new phone, but you don't want to pay that full price, just go for the one underneath. Because when the new one comes out, that one underneath tends to go down a bit. And by the time Ronnie had given me some money and I traded mine in, I think I ended up paying about £130. I got £95 for my old one because it's in very good condition. I always put it in a cover and I'm careful not dropping it and it's not scratched. I buy one of those, you know, those screens that you put on the front. I get one of those. If you buy one of those, my advice is, if you buy one of those screens to put on the front of your screen, a protector, don't try it yourself. Oh, they're a nightmare. You get all these little bubbles underneath and all that. And if you get a bubble, don't think, oh, well, I'll just get a little pin and do it. No, because it'll be raised then and it will do your head in. The thing to do is to go to an Apple store or somewhere like that where they put them on for you and it'll be perfect. And it's worth paying an extra few quid. You know, otherwise you're sitting there, you've got your mobile phone, you put this thing, oh, it's stuck to my thing. Oh, no. I've put a finger mark on there now. And then you start rubbing it like that and rubbing it. And you still end up with a couple of air bubbles and you can't get them out. Don't do it yourself. Take it into Apple and do it. Anyway, I got £95 for my phone. And I ended up having a new iPhone SE for about £120. Hey! Very happy with that. Thank you very much. Good morning to Rod Brown, who joins us this morning. Grant says he got it working. What the speaker or the Freeview player? Yes, you got them both working. But very unprofessional the way you put it together, dear. I mean, you didn't even use sellotape, love. At least when I put wires together, I twist them. I put a little bit of tape on there to stop people electronically accusing themselves. Yes. I keep getting electric shocks at the moment from keys and things like that. Do you do that? When I get home from work, if it's cold outside, I go to open the garage. And what I do with my key now, what could I use as a key? Let's use this battery. Pretend this battery is a key. Now, I don't want to use my own key on the show because you might see the shape and you might take a photo of that. You might take a photo of the shape of my key, have one made, and then break in here while I'm asleep. Anything could happen to me, dear. People could just let themselves in while I'm trying to sleep. While I am probably asleep, you know, very, very late in the morning, creep up the stairs, open my bedroom door and jump me. Yes. So pretend this battery is a key. And what I do is I hold the key very firmly and I touch it on the lock on the garage door. And then you see a little spark fly across and you don't get electrocuted then. If I kind of was to do that, it would go psst and oh, like that. Not very pleasant, dear. Strangely enough, I get that from water as well. If I put the tap on sometimes, I put the tap on, I go to wash my hands and I feel an electric shock jump from the water into my body or the other way around. I'm not quite sure what it is now. So what I do is I hold the key firmly and then the spark is transferred from my hand to the key, you see, and it jumps. There's today's physics. Perhaps I could do physics lessons as well. What do you reckon? Do you like the idea of a physics lesson? Shall I do physics lessons? Elaine says it's a date. There you go. See, so I'm going to bring my washing round to her and I'm going to tech up for Elaine. In Israel, yeah. Maybe I'll hire one of those electric bikes that you've got running all over Tel Aviv there. Electric bikes, very, very popular in Tel Aviv, let me tell you that. You don't, it's very quiet. You hear them coming, though. They kind of whir as they go. I was the only one with pedals, dear. Dennis says, I thought more had fallen out, dear. No, no more hair has fallen out. It's a good haircut for only £11. £11.25 with the tip. So generous. Let's have a look. Good morning to Paul Dow. Good morning, Paul. Nice to see you. I've had one of my anti-acid tablets this morning. No, not capsules. They're capsules, aren't they? Anti-acid capsules this morning as I was getting a little bit of a problem yesterday afternoon. Elaine's got a company phone, so her company pays for the phone and my calls. That is excellent news. Make them pay for it, Elaine. That's what I say. And also good morning to Kevin Webster, who's just joining us. Good morning, Kevin. Nice to see you, sir. As always, thank you to those of you that are sharing the show on your wall. That's very much appreciated. All right. Now, let me see what I've written down here. Watered garden. One of the things I do at karaoke, and I don't know why I do it, I chuck balls of paper at people. Does anyone else do that? Only small bits of paper. You know, they're not going to hurt or anything like that. But I wait until someone's... It's usually Mary I do. Mary from Ireland. She's the one I like to chuck little balls of paper at her. Just like that. As they're walking. As they're sitting there quietly at their table. I don't know why I do that. Sometimes I actually manage to get it in her wine or someone else's beer. Chucking bits of paper. Roy with the glasses, you know Roy. I'd like to chuck bits of paper at him. Eh? I don't know why I do that. Isn't that strange? And they chuck them back at me usually. Chris who sings dreary songs. Don't let the sun go. Oh, it's so dreary. Talking of dreary, this morning's Facebook status update comes from none other than Simon Keane. Now, Simon is a regular correspondent to this worldwide renowned multi-award winning television programme. Simon always writes in. We've got some messages coming up from yesterday's show from him, actually. But first of all, Simon's Facebook update from yesterday, it says, and I tell you this, I've just heard the English entry for the Eurovision Song Contest. Trust me, that is the best song from us for years. I'm banging 20 quid on us to win this year. Very, very good. I love it. But I might stick a fiver on Malta because I'm confident she is from Wales and Tom Jones is Welsh and Tom has a lot of respect worldwide. I think this is our year. I'm confident. Wow, what a brilliant song. Fabulous, duck. Is there something wrong with your ears, Simon? Our song is horrendous. It is dreary and boring. Are you sure you don't just fancy the bird? Is that what it is? Is it that you fancy the girl singing it, dear? I think there's something wrong with your ears, Simon. And honestly, you might stick a fiver on Malta because she's from Wales and Tom Jones is Welsh. Don't you think that's a bit of a loose connection there, my friend Simon? Stick a fiver on Malta because I'm confident she is from Wales and Tom Jones is Welsh and Tom has a lot of respect worldwide. Well, what's Tom got to do with the Maltese song sung by someone from Wales? What planet are you on this morning, dear? Our song is horrendous, as is most of the songs this year. They are so dreary and boring. It's supposed to be a happy occasion. We are going to do no good. And apart from that, they all hate us anyway because of Brexit. Save yourself £20. Put that £20 back in your pocket and buy yourself a few more drinks, Simon. Honestly, it is horrendous, that song. It is awful. It is not going to win. I'll tell you what, why don't you bet me £20 that it's going to win? And I'll match that £20 that it won't win. So you bet me £20. And whoever it is has to send the other one the 20 quid. How's that? I'll wait for your response. Thank you very much, Simon. That is not going to win now. Oh, dear, dear me. Elaine says, I love my country. And we've already won 3 times, but Israel's going to lose big time this year. I haven't heard the Israeli one, actually, Elaine. Haven't heard that yet. I remember, and hallelujah, you know, hallelujah, da, da, da. My great nephew, George, that's my niece's little boy, who's 4. That's one of his favourite songs. He sings it in the car. And the funny thing is, he likes to sing a particular version of it, Elaine. Oh, yes. You get it up on YouTube and he'll say, no, not that one. And he'll say, oh, you're annoying me now, Chris. I annoy him, apparently. I annoy him. He tells me, Chris, you annoy me. 4 years old. Chris, you annoy me. That's what he says. Anyway, he loves the song Hallelujah and he knows all the words to it. We love that song. And I quite like a bunny be a bunny bay. Da, da, da. A bunny be a bunny bay. Ba, ba, da, da. Do you remember when Dana International won it with Diva? And they do you remember watching it? You must have watched it. And she came over onto the stage to collect her award. She was so drunk she fell ass over tit. Do you remember that? Oh, dear. She was absolutely wrecked. She came over to collect the reward. I think she had it in her hand and fell over. Oh, dear. My favourite Israeli song, which didn't win, was Light a Candle. Do you remember that one? Light a candle with me. 1,000 candles in the dark will open our heart. I love that one. Light a candle, yes. Very, very nice. Elaine says she fell over in her Gaultier gown. Yes, she did. Adam says, are your acid capsules called omeprazole? I don't know. No, I don't think they are called that. I think it's something beginning with L, possibly. I can bring them up on the next show if you like, and I'll if you're with me next time, Adam, I'll have a look. But they're fantastic. Honestly, they're great. If you have one, I don't have one a day, sort of one every 3 days. That seems to do me. No problem at all then. Absolutely no problem whatsoever. Wonderful they are. I don't know how they work. Very strange, very strange. Good. Good morning to Stafford Blake. Good morning, Stafford. We're not taking calls at the moment, Staffy. We're just chatting at the moment, lovey. We're chatting, all right? So there we are. Right. Let's see. Just wanted to read some messages out from yesterday's show, Boys and Girls, that came in a little later. 1 second, let me just get those up for you. Just find those. Oh, I've got to scroll down. God, haven't I done a lot of posts yesterday? I don't realise sometimes how many posts I do. But I try for my posts not to be depressing like some people's are. You know what I mean? Oh, just split up with my boyfriend. I'm really hurt today. We don't want to see that, do you? We want happy posts. Happy, happy, happy. That's what we want. So on yesterday's show, where are we? There we are. Simon Keane. Simon, once again, he always watches the whole show, Simon. And we were talking about squirrels. And I had squirrels in my loft a few years ago. And let me tell you, it is not funny. It is not funny. Simon said yesterday, oh my God, squirrels in the loft. That is scary to think that they could set your house on fire. My word. I once had wasps in our loft. That was scary. Yeah, my auntie had wasps. My auntie. And the bloke came 3 or 4 times. And he said, well, there's none there. And she would keep finding them in the house. Well, the only thing is when wasps get in the house, they tend to just go up and down the window looking for a way out, don't they? If you're looking for a way out, don't stand in my way. That was a lovely song by Odyssey. If you're looking for a way out. So wasps, not nice at all. But squirrels, if you ever get squirrels summoned, you've got to get them out of there. Call a bloke straight in or try and do it yourself. And you'll never get a squirrel twice using the same method. Squirrels are considered a pest. If you catch one, you have to dispose of it. You're not allowed to let it go. That's not a joke. You need to dispose of it by whatever reason. And I caught mine. One was on a sticky pad. Okay, so these are like bits of cardboard. And you put them down. Squirrel puts a paw on it, can't get it off. Puts the other paw on, can't get it off. Not a nice way to go. I'm afraid they dehydrate to death. Dreadful way to go. One was caught on a trap because they're clever bastards, those squirrels. Oh, they are. They are clever little sods, right? And if one is caught on a pad, no other squirrels will come near that pad. Now, these sticky pads, very, very good. Do not put them outside because they are completely indiscriminate against other animals. You'll have a little bird land on there or something like that, you know. Don't never put those outside. Only in the place where the problem is, i.e. your attic. Somewhere like that. So you put them down. Another one was caught with one of those normal traps. Like that. Another one was caught in a live cage type thing. So you put peanuts in the cage. Squirrel comes in, the door closes. Yes, so you have to use different methods. If you've got a few of them, you have to use a different method for each one because they get used to it, you see. They know. They're not stupid, those squirrels. Oh, no, they learn. Simon also says, my dad used to go to Jumble Car Boot Sales, which we were just talking about, and buy random things like something for £2, then took them to auctions and sold them for £30 or £40. Yeah, it's a good way to make money if you know what you're looking for. I wouldn't know what I'm looking for. You know, but this is something that my nephew and his dad does. Gary has started doing it. My nephew, Gary, he was 32 this last week. He was 32 last week. And he's the one with the severely disabled daughter. And him and his wife have a hard time, you know, looking. They do their best. But they do have a hard life now doing all this stuff. And they're always a little bit short of money. And he's just started doing this. buying stuff from various different sources. I did mention jumble sales, but the thing is, you don't see, I don't know if you get them up there, Sam, we just don't see them down here anymore. I can't remember when I last saw an advert for a jumble sale. And I used to go to them. I used to help at the Scouts one in the 1970s. I belonged to the First Roehampton Scout Group. And every couple of months or so, we'd have a jumble sale. And there'd be so much stuff, loads and loads of stuff. Not just clothes, but in those days, you could take in electrical items, old record players. And I had three or four of these old record players in my house. Records, there would be records, radios, kitchen, knives and forks, plates, all sorts of things at jumble sales. And for a few pennies, you know, you could have an entire new tea set. Wonderful they work. Don't see them anymore, jumble sales. But anyway, Gary goes on eBay. His friends offer him stuff, you know, oh, do you want this? And, oh, what do you want for that? And he'll offer him something. I think last week, would he want me to tell you this? Yeah, I don't see why not. Yeah. Last week, he got, I think it was two mobility scooters and a motorbike, or it was just two mobility scooters or a motorbike. I can't remember exactly what it was now. And what the bloke wanted was 20 quid and a wallpaper steamer. That was the swap that the bloke wanted. So I think he gave him 20 quid, or it might not have been any money. But he basically went down to B&Q and bought a steamer for, I don't know how much they are, for 30 quid or whatever. Gave him that. He took the two mobility scooters, cleaned them up, serviced them a little bit. And he sold for like 300 or 400 quid. That's it. That's a little business, that is. Nothing wrong. No one's being ripped off. No one's being ripped off. And he'll go on eBay, buy stuff on there, look around auctions, little notes in shop windows, that sort of thing. And he'll buy the item, do it up and sell it on. Very clever. If you can do something like that. I can't do stuff like that. I can't really repair things. I can't wait to get started on this shoe rack, actually. I might do that this afternoon. I don't know. If I've got nothing else to do. So, yes, I don't know if you've got jumble sales up there. Darren. Hello, Darren Lee Wicks. Hello, sir. I agree with you 100% about what you said about the Black Cap yesterday. It was and hopefully will be again a very, very special place. Yes, the Black Cap is somewhere where I had a wonderful time. I spent 18 years working there. Probably the first 13 were really good. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Yeah, the last five were a little bit, you know, it's just sort of hanging on in there. You know, I should have gone at about 12 or 13, I think. But certainly the first 13, right the way through the 90s, end of the 80s, right the way through the 90s, I had a wonderful, wonderful time there. And it really was a big part of my life. My mum actually died while I was working there. Yes. I got a phone call one night. Oh, I'll never forget, it was a Saturday night. And it was a cabaret act on called Lizzie Drip. And I got this phone call. Do you want to come to the hospital? Your mum's deteriorated. And I said to the bloke, to the nurse on the phone, I said, can it wait a little bit? She said, well, how long? I said, well, about another half an hour. She said, maybe. OK. So I went in and saw the drag act at Lizzie Drip. Lovely man. His name is Bo. B-E-A-U. Don't hear that name much, do you? Only on Beauty and the Beast. And I said, what time are you going on? He said, oh, I'll be about half an hour. Why? I said, can you go on any quicker? He said, what's up? I said, my mum's dying. He said, well, go. I said, well, I can't. He said, why not? I said, I can't go. I said, I can't go until you've gone on. He said, yes, you can. I said, no, I can't. He said, right, give me 2 minutes. And in 2 minutes, he came on that stage. I put the show on. He went, and I was prepared. I'd already had this. It's a DAT tape. It's like a tape, but they're much longer. They're like 3 or 4 hours long. And I'd already made this tape because I was expecting this. And show went on. Show finished. I put the tape in, rushed out the door, drove to the hospital. Too late. Too late, unfortunately. But, it is very special for me. Had my 32nd birthday there as well. That was a really good birthday. A guy called Paul Flowers had made me this wonderful birthday cake. It was like a sponge cake covered in this cream, and he'd put all sorts of sweets on it, like, you know, those matchstick chocolate matchstick things, and Quality Streets all pushed into the icing around the. It was covered in sweets. It was absolutely delicious, that cake. And also, in them, so many memories I've got there. Also, that's where I met my best friend, Ronnie, years ago. And it wasn't a best friend. I went out with him. Do you want to know? I was DJing. And at that point, the DJ box was at the end of the bar. And then barman come up. Oh, someone wants to buy you a drink. I said, all right. I said, who's that then? He said, that one down there. And there was Ronnie standing in the most awful pair of dungarees. They really were awful. And he had one strap down there. And I thought, oh, what has he got on? Anyway, you don't say anything. So I went down and thanked him, and that was it. And then shortly after, we started going out again. I went out with him for about a year. Unfortunately, at that time, how old was I? 28, 27, I was 28, I think. And I mucked him about. I was terrible. Because, of course, you was a DJ. You had offers coming left, right and centre. In those days, I couldn't stick to one person. I was dreadful. I was really, really dreadful. And then at some point, he done it to me. And I didn't like that at all. And anyway, we split up and... Then there was a gap. Then we became friends again. And then there was another gap. And now he's just my best friend. Now I couldn't. There's no way I could be his other half. No. Absolutely no way at all. You kind of get to know people, don't you? And do you know what I mean? Fantastic as a best friend. But, you know, at the end of sort of a day, you can say, all right, bye-bye, and close your door. I'm sure he will say exactly the same to you if you was to ask him about me. So that's how I met Ronnie in the Black Cab as well. And lots of friends, lots of wonderful people in there, thousands of acquaintances, but very few friends that I managed to keep in contact with. There was a guy called Jason. He used to be the chef. Wayne was one of the assistant managers. Jimmy, who I still work with now, although I'm about to finish working with him in Clapham. Sharon Stone. There was David Rosen, another DJ there. And I do bump into people who I haven't seen for years and years in Central Station, actually. A lot of them come in there and you haven't seen them for like 15, 20 years, because it's 10 years this year since I left. 10 years since, and I left the Black Cab. I didn't get sacked. I actually left the Black Cab. I decided it was finished, you know, for me. So I left. But so many wonderful, wonderful memories in there, really. Yeah, fantastic. Let's have a look. Alan says there should be a karaoke competition. Any thoughts on that? No competitions, Alan. Never. I will not do a karaoke competition. They are a nightmare because the people who are, how can I put this, overconfident think they should win. They come up and tell you, even if I'm not the judge, and even if there was a chance of me doing a karaoke competition, I would absolutely refuse point blank to be a judge. And people come up to you and they tell you that they are so good that they should be the ones that win. It is horrendous. Horrendous. And when they don't win, they come up and they tell you how disgusted they are because they are, and I quote, the best singer. People actually come up and tell you this. Now, I've said this so many times, Alan. I've said this so many times on the show. They actually come up and tell you how fantastic a singer they are, and it should have been them that won the contest. And they're not coming back anymore. They usually come back a little bit later on. But that's what they say. And you start getting emails. Dodgy emails. I should have won that. I'm a fantastic... And it's all like that. Me. Dreadful. Or other people. Oh, it was a fix. They were always going to win. And all this. Oh, the judge knows him. And all this. No. I will not do a karaoke competition ever. No. Absolutely. And the other thing is that happens, some people who come week in, week out, suddenly see that there's going to be a competition and they don't come anymore. And they don't come anymore because they don't think they are good enough to win a competition or even be in a competition. And the funny thing is, generally, one of those persons would probably win it, not the people that come and tell you how good they are. They're never going to win. Wrong attitude, my friend. So, no. No, I won't do a karaoke competition. And that is the reason. It's horrendous. All right. Back to your messages then. Good morning to Ray Reynolds, who joins us this morning, who says, Heidi High from Matt Plin's Holiday Camp. Heidi High. Johnny Key, who comes to the karaoke, does that song, Heidi High. And he's very, very good at it. Always gets the crowd going with that. Good morning, Ray. Nice to chat to you on the phone this morning, dear. Thank you, Elaine, for your kind comments. A very good morning to the lovely Ian Ellis. I hope your gorgeous little dog is all right this morning. You're looking after your little boy, aren't you? Little boy Blue. Morning, Ian. Elaine says, I can't ride a bicycle, so maybe when you get here, we can rent mobility scooters. So we can ride up and down the Tel Aviv promenade. That's nice. That is nice. That is very nice indeed, Elaine. Do you know what? They had a problem at Disney with this, Disney in Florida. Literally, people were renting mobility scooters, wheelchairs, that sort of thing, simply because Disney are really good with disabled people. They are fantastic with disabled people, and they would rent stuff like this. So they could jump the queues on the rides. Ah, shock horror. Don't be horrified. This was actually happening at Disney. And they, in the end, I do believe that they stopped the certain things for the disabled people because there were so many people taking the mick. Isn't that dreadful? I couldn't do something like that because you're alone. You know, rent a mobility scooter or a wheelchair or a pair of crutches or something like that to jump a queue. Wouldn't you think him above would get you back for that? You know, karma. Very, very bad. Adam Blue says, when you're getting out of the car, maybe something synthetic fabric or something causing your electric shocks. I don't know what it is, actually, Adam. I get it a lot. I can't wear fleece. You know that fleece, because that's not wool, is it? It's some sort of synthetic. If I wear fleece, oh, my God, I just keep getting electrocuted every time I touch something metal. Maybe I'm just full of radiation, boys and girls. I am the human Chernobyl. I am the mobile human Chernobyl. That's me. A very good morning to Jimmy Butler International. Morning, Jimmy. Surely you don't want to call in, do you, Jim? Why you want to call in this morning? Just a moment, please. I don't really want to open the phone lines this morning, so you've probably gone there. I reckon you've gone. I was going to open the phone lines this morning, but I'm not going to now. There you go. I've sent you my phone. So if you call in, because I all want to hear, you all want to hear Prince Jimmy from Woodall Spa, don't you, my nephew? Hey, but he might well have gone there. He might have given up waiting. Good morning to Phil Buxton. Good morning, Phil, who says, never retire. Keep the live streams coming. Hours of entertainment while I'm working. We do our best, Phil. It's just like having a little chat amongst friends. That's what this show is all about. Having a little chat amongst friends. That's what it is. Good morning to Lee Cobby. Morning, Lee. You're a bit late this morning, dear. God's sake, 20 to 12. We've been here for an hour. Where were you, Lee? Do try and keep up. Are you not getting the little notifications? Are you not a subscriber? Are you not a... I like that word, subscriber. Lee says, good morning, Chris. Being lazy, watching your show, still in bed. Dear. Oh, you're not having one of those dreadful duvet days, are you? Please, you can't have a duvet day. You've got to get up and do stuff. Absolutely. Lee says, should get up soon. Had a late night doing a photo booth at a 40th birthday bash. Have you ever done a photo booth? No, Lee, I haven't. What is that? Is it like you just put the box up? Is it like the photo booth that we used to see in Woolworths and places like that, where you sit in a little box, close the curtain, put your money in and then do various poses, you know? Is it like that? Or do you actually have to do something? Once you've set it up, do you just walk away and leave it? Photo booths are good things, aren't they? You'll have to tell us more about that, Lee. Tell us more about your photo booth. OK, good morning to Wayne Martin, who says, let Jimmy speak, dear. You could have a rest. Well, I think he's gone, to be honest. He probably got bored of waiting for me to reply that. I have been in full flow this morning, Wayne. Hope you were. Hope your karaoke was good last night, dear. I had a nice night last night. A little bit quieter than normal because we got the bank holiday. And these bank holidays are on top of each other this year, aren't they? Got another one coming up. So looking forward to that. And I'm there Monday as well. You must be down in the corner house tonight, I guess, are you? I'm sure you're looking forward to it. That's an excellent night, that is, really, the corner house in Maidenhead. Excellent. All right, let's do a couple of news stories this morning. There we are. Now, we've got we've got boxing tonight, haven't we? We've got boxing tonight. Have you seen the boxers? Oh, gorgeous. I can't decide which one I like the best. I don't know if I like the white one or is he black or mixed race? Which is the correct term for that? I think black. I think I prefer the black one. I do. Isn't he gorgeous? Have you seen him? Oh, my God. Well, it's all happening tonight. The only thing is, I did see them both on like one of those. What is that thing called? You know, when they're looking at each other like that, like fiercely like that. I don't know. I can't get my wires stuck from my mouse. Hang on a minute. I don't know if I'd be able to do that sort of fierce look that they do. You know, that look that they look at each other. Like that. No, that's not like. How can I look angry? How do I look angry? Let me just think to myself that someone has just come up who's only just put a karaoke slip. I said, when am I going on? I want to go on now. No, it doesn't work, does it? It's got to be like a fighting look. No, that's a disapproving look. I can't do it. Can't do it. Anyway, so these two were at the like press conference thing the day before or a couple of days before. And they come on with their little shorts on and their super fit bodies. Oh, God. Especially the black one. What's his name? Anthony Joshua. Oh, God. Is he the black one or is he the white one? I don't know, actually. Hang on a minute. Let me see. Oh, yes, he's the black one. That's the one I like. So Anthony is my future husband, boys and girls. And they come on and they look at each other meanly. The only thing is they were smiling at each other. It kind of doesn't have the same effect, does it? It really doesn't. There is one. There's actually a YouTube video. And if you type in boxers kissing, where there's two boxers looking at each other, and you can tell one hates the other more than he hates him. The one that hates him, and he goes like this, and he goes, and the one that knows that he hates him, he goes like that. And the boxer goes, blah, and he gives him a kiss on the lips. And he goes mad. I'm hoping to get a kiss off Joshua at some point. And no, it's Anthony Joshua. Maybe I'll get a kiss off him. And in the Daily Mail this morning, it says, he's a man mountain and consumes a mountain of food. Look, this is what he eats. Hang on a minute. Where's the list? Here's what he eats. He is. You type it in. Type it in. I can't show you a picture on there. I haven't got one prepared. I wonder if I can. Oh, I don't want to muck about. Something might go terribly wrong, mightn't it? Shall I try it? What have we got to lose? We've got nothing to lose, have we? Hang on. Let me try and do this on the... Because I don't think I've done this on the fly before. So, if it all goes off now, then it was all in the purpose of learning something, okay? So... And, oh, hang on a minute. Why not? I can't write anything on that. I wonder why that is. Ah, that's the broadcast one. That's why. How do I open another blooming thing then? I don't think I can do it. How do I open another tab in Chrome? It says secure. What does that mean? Secure. Oh, hang on. Cookies. Microphone. Hang on. Restore, move, back, reload. Show as tab. Oh, yes. Right. So I've shown that as tab now. And now, right. What's his name? Anthony Joshua. Where is he? Oh, hang on. Pictures. Where's the blooming pictures? Oh, p- pictures. Oh, there he is. Now, do you want the fully clothed one or the one not clothed? Oh, look at him. I'm trying to get a full frontal for you. There he is. That'll do. That'll do. Oh, that'll do. Right, let me try. Oh, hang on. Let me try and get that. Save image as. Now, where's that going? Videos and pictures for live show. Anthony. Anth. That'll do. Anth. Are you still with us? Is this still working? Can you still see me? Right, so if I do a plus and plus and pick. Just a minute now, I'll be with you. Oh no, we've all gone. Everything's disappeared now. Oh. There you are, back again. Right, so how do I do this? All right, so I know you can hear me. Just a minute. Please enter the name of the scene. Okay. Oh, dear. Stay there. Oh, I know what I've got to do. Here we are. Image. Create new. Browse. Oh, it's a bit mucking about, isn't it, really? Where is he? Well, we will get it, though. I will get it. It will happen. Just a minute. I'm just finding a picture. There he is. Anth. And okay. There he is. Let me just open him up a bit. How do we... I think we can fit this to screen somewhere. Just a moment. Order transform. Where's the flip? Fit to screen. How's that? There he is. Anthony Joshua. Come on, girls. Yes, please. Look at him. Oh, my God. Who wants to be laying next to that tonight? Yes, please, mummy. Ha, 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 ha. Come on, you must like him. How can you say you wouldn't like him? You've got to... Oh, yes, please. There's our boxer. He's lovely, isn't he? Well, we got there in the end. I'll have to work on that a bit, see if I can find pictures and things on the fly. Diane. Good morning, Diane, who says tasty. Tasty? That's an understatement, dear. I would willingly sell my entire house and all its contents just for one date with him. Please. Thank you, Diane. Yes. Good morning to Jason, who says, Duvet Day, another American trash import. Come out of that duvet now, Jason. Get out and do something, dear. You can't be laying on... That's how you get heart attacks. That's how you get heart attacks and diabetes. You'll end up on the diabetes table at Central Station. You're wondering what that is. I might explain it to you in private one day, dear. Kevin Webster says, not for me. Really? How can you not like him? God's sake, man. Elaine says, good God. Rachel says he looks better in the dark. No! We want as many lights on him as possible. Thank you very much. Oh, dear, dear me. Better late than never. Rachel, you're very, very late today, dear. How can you be so late? Good. Let's have a look. Ah, Lee says the photo booth thing is more funny with props and people who have had a few drinks and clothes come off. Do they really? No. What, in a photo booth? Dear, dear me. Awful. Elaine says on the subject of the people that... that was a serious comment, actually. There were people who used to hire wheelchairs and things to get into Disney and to jump queues. Elaine says, I'm a cancer survivor and I would never take advantage of any disease for my benefit. It's a dreadful thing to do. There's a lot of people that do that, Elaine. I know an awful lot of people who do that. Go on and on about things that are wrong with them. And there's nothing wrong with them at all. Maybe the odd twinge here and there. That's about it. God's sake. I mean, you don't hear me going on about my IBS, do you, dear? You know, I don't run into McDonald's and say, can you serve me soon? Because I've got IBS and I might have to rush out to the toilet, dear. Not me, lovey. Thank you very much. No, not for Kevin. OK, fair enough, Kevin. Well, that's OK. That's one less person for me to worry about, isn't it? If you don't want him, because I'll have him. Thank you. Ray Reynolds says, today we are sponsored by Sky Box Office. This is the Chris Reardon Show. Anyway, let's go back to the story there. about the about this fight tonight. So he has 4,500 to 5,000 calories a day. My God, and he don't put on any weight. I walked past a bag of crisps 10 years ago and have been putting in weight ever since. It's terrible. Look what he has for breakfast: 5 eggs with a couple of avocados and a little bit of lime seasoned, plenty of spinach and 3 pieces of toast. Blender full of fresh fruit with oats, yogurt, milk and generous helping of honey. I have honey on my porridge in the morning. Do you like honey? It's better than sugar, isn't it? Or is it just the same? I don't know. Lunch, a big serving of pasta with vegetables, tomatoes, 2 full chicken breasts. Dessert is a large pot of yogurt with fresh fruit, nuts, honey and granola. Big portions to go with those beautiful big arms of his. Look at that. Dinner, fish, sweet potato, quinola. What's that, quinola? Is that a plant? Quinola, what's that? Quinola? Right, they probably got that in Waitrose. Fruit juice, rice. Dinner tends to be protein-based and includes dairy or nuts to fill him up before bed. He will also have a protein shake made from the protein casein, which releases quite slowly throughout the night, aiding recovery. God's sake. And he does all this training. Oh, is a picture of him as a little boy there. What's that? What is he eating there? God, he's got a little... a lot of food for a little boy. That's what he eats. Isn't that a lot of money? Isn't that a lot of... That would cost him an arm and a leg. And there is a picture of him and the other bloke. This is in the Daily Mail this morning. Or it might have been yesterday's one. There's a picture of him and the other bloke, and they just don't look like they hate each other. They look like mates. I'm not sure that's the right way to be doing boxing, really. Good morning to James Clark. You're a bit late today, James. There's a lot of late comers today. Were you all getting up late this morning or something? What's going on there? James says, did you get your free Metro crisps? No, I'm afraid I didn't. No, I didn't get up to the train station yesterday for my free copy of the Metro. Ray Reynolds says, let me through, am I diabetic? No, I'm sorry, Ray, you're not going to get on that diabetic table. No, you're not going on the diabetes table in there, my love. All right. All right, let's do today's birthdays and then we'll disappear this morning. Happy birthday to all-round top guy, Graham Lang, who's 43 years old today. Happy birthday, Graham. Graham has met Theresa May on several occasions. Our hero, Mother Teresa, who is going to save us all from the evils of everything. She is going to save us all. Yes. Yes. Happy birthday, Graham. Happy birthday today to Fat Fox. Fox Gilmard is 36 years old today. Happy birthday, Fox. Jason Allen is 29 years old today. Jason is a bit important to this programme because he designed the United Kingdom Talk logo. Yes, that sort of Union Jack with the kind of shimmering silver bits there. Happy birthday, Jason. Happy birthday today to Darren Birch, 36 years old today. Anthony Ratcliffe. I haven't seen you for ages, Anthony. I'm going to be leaving the Two Brewers soon in a few weeks' time. Okay, so that's really the only place I see you now, isn't it? So do pop in within the next couple of weeks to say goodbye, wouldn't you? I'm not dying. I'm just going somewhere. I'm just going from there. So happy birthday, Anthony. I can't believe you're 34. Happy birthday, Anthony. You're in what was my favourite age period. My favourite age period was between 32 and 47. That was certainly wasn't my 20s. Oh, I had a rough time in my 20s, let me tell you that now. But 32 to 47 was my favourite age. So happy birthday, Anthony. Stuart Watts, it's his birthday today. Looking super cool in the shades. And Christopher Sweet. Hello, Christopher. Last place I saw you at was that lovely little club in Waterloo, wasn't it? You know the one? You know the one with the locker room? And the lovely glass doors on the outside. Lovely to see you, Christopher. Happy birthday to you all. Let's sing the song this morning. Oh, hang on. That's the wrong bit of music there. One moment, please. Here we go. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Have a nice birthday on this Saturday. Now, tonight, I'll be doing a little bit of DJing tonight and also hosting Cabaret. Now, if you're in the King's Cross area tonight, namely Central Station again, because I do most Saturdays. I do almost every Saturday there now. I think I've got just three off until the end of the year. They book me for most of them. I'll be hosting Cabaret tonight. And the Cabaret tonight is Miss Jason. Miss Jason is, in my mind, one of the top cabaret artist drag queens of all time. She's absolutely on the same level as Sandra and people like that. So that is the Cabaret tonight on this Saturday, the 29th of April. Starts at 10:30, the show. When I say I do a bit of DJing, it's not club DJing. It's just playing a few tracks. You know, people asking for requests, a little bit of chat from me. And then the main event for the night is, of course, the show, which should be on stage by 10:30. OK, so Cabaret tonight, 10:30 Cabaret with Miss Jason at Central Station. Now, don't forget, once again, we've got a new karaoke starting tomorrow night. Now, tomorrow night it's on. Then there's two Saturdays. Then there's two Sundays off because I can't do them. And then we start every week. And tomorrow night, karaoke, that's Sunday the 30th of April. And that will be at the Camden Eye. Very, very close. It's almost on top of Camden Tube Station. If you want to join us there, the Camden Eye, 8 p.m. till 11 p.m. tomorrow night on Sunday night. Okay, that's it today, boys and girls. Enjoy the rest of your Saturday. Thank you very much for watching and listening, and I'll see you again very soon. Bye bye now.